In this tutorial video, we want to go over some basic concepts of working through your D2L class. Now, whether your class is actually CIS 118 or it's something different, D2L will function pretty much the same no matter what the class is. So for instance, this is a master class. This is what an instructor uses to create the courses for each semester. So it's going to look a little bit different than what you would see as a student, but again, it should function pretty much the same. So when you come in, you'll see the home page, and you should see some banner or text that tells you what class you're in. You can also see the course information number here, and you'll usually have widgets on the left-hand side that are important information that your instructor has given to you. So for this class, it's how to buy the software for the class. And then you'll also see news items, and these are the latest things that they want to get out to you so that you're successful in the course. Also, these can be news items from the person who administers D2L. So let's say there's a problem or we're going to have an outage sometime during the weekend. You'll see a news item there, and it'll help you to plan ahead. So make sure you're paying attention to this area. Now, every course should have a content page. In this course, you can see we have a couple of different what we call modules, and this helps us to organize content or topics into units. So we have our Intro to CIS 118, and we have a bunch of different topics here. So I'll go ahead and click on Getting the Student Data Files, and this will bring up a new screen that you can read. This might be lecture notes, it might be an assignment, etc. And when you're done looking at that, you can go to the next topic in the module, or you can click next here, and it gives you a check mark saying you have viewed this topic. That lets you know what you have seen and what you haven't. You can also download it here. So let's say it's a Word document and you want to be able to keep it on your flash drive and look at it later. You can click download here. Now you can go all the way up to the top, and this is where you can also view the content in a new window if it's not perhaps fitting correctly. You can go to next or previous and you can print it. So let's go back to the table of contents, and again we can see all of our different modules, but when we come to the table of contents we can see all of the modules and what's in each of the modules. So this is maybe where the course syllabus would be. Again, this is a brand new course and it's a master course, so we don't see the syllabus, but this is where you can find it in the content area. The news is just the news tool, and it's the same thing you see on the course homepage, but if you ever need to go back and look at old news items, you can come to the news tool. Your class may or may not have this. Class list is where you can see everybody who's in the class. And you can also see a couple of different things. You can see a green dot tells you that that person is online right now. And you can also email a person. So let's say I want to email my instructor. I can click on her name and it'll bring up an email window. Now this is an internal D2L email, so don't put something like jaylene@hotmail.com. Regular email addresses aren't going to work in here because it's only for this system. But this is a way you can email your classmates, maybe some group work members, or you can email your instructor. Next we have the Dropbox. The Dropbox is where you turn your assignments in. So as you can see, this class has a ton of Dropboxes, and again, this is a master class, so they probably wouldn't have this many Dropboxes, but you can usually tell from the Dropbox what assignment it's going to be, what score you got on it once it's graded, and if you've turned anything in. So if you've turned anything in, this will change to a 1. So we'll see that in a second. Feedback will be the notes that your instructor leaves you, and then what due date it is. So these don't have due dates right now, but if it did, it would show the actual due date, and if it was closed, let's say that deadline is passed, you wouldn't be able to click on this Dropbox and it would be in red. So let's go ahead and go to Word Chapter 1 Assignment and see what this Dropbox looks like and how to turn in the assignments. So any instructions that your teacher has left you will be showing here. And then it'll tell you right now you haven't submitted any files. So let's go ahead and click Add a File, and it's going to ask you where is that file. So go ahead and click upload, and that's going to let you look for that file. So it's on my flash drive. I'll click on flash drive, go into my class, into that unit, and there is my project. Now, be aware that no matter what class you're in, you should probably put your name or at least your last name in that file so that your instructor can distinguish your project from somebody else's and that you don't have any problems with your grades as a result. So I'll click open and it's going to upload here, and I'm not done. This is just saying this is the one I want to upload. So if I wanted to do 3 or 4, I could keep doing it until I had them all, and then I need to click done. And now you can see there's one file. Here's the file. So if you made a mistake, you can hit the X to delete it, and I can leave a comment. And you usually want to leave a comment that's going to help maybe your instructor assess or grade that project. Had a tricky time with the header. Okay, click submit. And that's how you know that it's actually working. When you submit and it says submission successful, and you can click to make sure it's the right one, and it's telling you what time, and it sent you a confirmation email. Keep those emails, because if you turn something in and something happens to it, we're all human and we make a mistake. If something happens to it, that email is your proof that you turned it in, let's say on time or even early. So I'll go ahead and click done. And let's go ahead and see how this looks. When you've submitted an assignment, all of a sudden in the submissions column, you can see that there's a 1 instead of 0, and I can click on that 1. And that allows me to go in and see what I've turned in. Let's say I accidentally turned in the wrong thing to the wrong Dropbox. So this helps me to figure out what I've turned in, and I can reopen it. If I ever lose that file, it's still here. I can reopen it by clicking on it here. And it tells you that this has been unread by you. All right, let's move on. So when you go to quizzes, from here, a good rule of thumb is when you're taking a quiz to save as you go. So let's go ahead and see how this works. I'll click on this quiz and you'll see some instructions. Start the quiz and it'll give you more instructions, and then click OK. And however your instructor has set this up, maybe it has a time limit, maybe it doesn't. Sometimes you can take more than one attempt at a quiz, and sometimes you just have that one chance. So let's say I'm going through this quiz and I know the answer to this, and I'm just going to guess. I don't actually know. I'm not even reading it. Instead of clicking through all of these like this, what happens if your computer has a power outage or something happens to your internet connection? You don't want to have to do this whole quiz again. So our recommendation is when you answer a quiz question, click save, and you can see now this one is a full color icon. That tells me that I finished that question. So let me go ahead and hit save on number 2 and save on number 3 so I can tell that I've done those. And let's say I get to number 4 and I don't know the answer to that, so I want to leave it for later. And let's say I answer that and answer this one and keep going through the whole quiz. That's a visual indicator that I need to go back to number 4. So I can click number 4 and it's going to jump me back to that spot on the page, and I can answer that question toward the end. Again, this is good for when your computer goes out or your power goes out, so you don't have to redo this quiz, or at least every question in this quiz. So let me go to the very bottom and I can save all my responses, and then I need to submit it. It's not enough just to hit save all responses. Hit submit and it's going to warn me because I haven't actually answered all of them, and then I'll submit. Yes, I do want to submit, and it kind of asks you that over and over and over again. So it's telling me what my grade is, so I kind of failed that quiz. And if your instructor has allowed you, there will be a link somewhere around here that you can click on it and see what the questions were, what you got right, what you got wrong, and it depends on what settings they set up. And they might do this after the quiz has ended so that you can't, you know, share your answers with somebody else. All right, so from here, you can go to grades, and I don't think this class is going to show you grades. Oh, yes, it will. This is what your grades look like. So you're going to see the points that you got for each of the things you've already done and what percentage, and it should show you, if you get any feedback, it should show you somewhere the feedback that your instructor leaves you. And then sometimes if they set up their class, they'll have the final grade calculated down here. Or in this class, we actually have an overall grade that shows you your progress as you go. Now, in terms of your other D2L classes, there might be some more links up here to different tools. Don't be afraid to just go in and play. And then when you look up here, anytime you have a red dot, that's telling you there's something new. So this is telling you there are some new news items or new updated things that you need to look at. So my grade was updated for the quiz I just took. And then I have some announcements for some of my classes. And this one is your email, and it's telling you you have new email. So Dropbox submission receipt, and I can read that and see when I turn my assignment in. So I hope this tutorial video will help you adapt to your D2L class. Don't be afraid to ask your instructor questions or click on these links and explore what's happening with each of these tools and how they might benefit you in your course. When you're finished, you need to make sure you log out. So you can go to your account and choose log out. Incidentally, if you want to add a profile picture or change some of your account settings, this is where you do it too. So I'll go ahead and log out, and I'm done with my course.